Hi everybody, my name is Rupa, working as assistant person Chaitral Engineering College. I'm dealing the subject electrical machines too, and in the today's topic is types of capacitor start motors. So in the already we have discussed before three types of motors. So this is the fourth one, single voltage non-reversible with magnetic switch type. Okay, so in before thermostat, thermostat type, single voltage reversible with thermostat type. So I am telling the connections. See here, a bimetallic strip of thermostat is used with the, see here, this is a thermostat and the terminals are T, TL and L. So T is the one end of the thermostat and TL is other end, and other end is connected to the supply here. And L, this is the L point which is connected to the running winding and switch and the capacitor. So see here, in the case of capacitor start motors, these are used in refrigerators. So there are total three LEDs will be brought out of four terminals. So three LEDs which are brought out are marked as T, TL and L. So this thermostat is connected to T and TL. Okay. And the capacitor is between L and the unmarked terminal and the supply lines to TL and L. Okay. So coming to now single voltage non-reversible type. So such motors, these motors are also commonly used in refrigerators where there is not possible to use centrifugal switch. Okay, so the circuit diagram is similar to that before I showed you this one. So as their application needs only just one direction of rotation, these motors are not connected for reversing, revolving in only one direction, these motors are used. So one disadvantage of the capacitor start motors are these are having magnetic switch lines in the possibility that if any slight overload occurs, the plunger may operate. So what happens if the plunger operates? It connects the starting winding circuit to the supply. Again, the starting winding circuit will be connected to the supply. Okay, so as we design this starting winding up to only very short periods, that means 3 seconds or less, it will burn out. Because as it is connected, we have to immediately take off the starting winding. So it is not possible in such a low time. So the winding may burn out. So this is single voltage non-reversible magnetic type switch. Next one. Two voltage non-reversible type. So these motors here are operated from two AC voltages, either from 110 voltages or 220 voltages, and 440 voltages also they can operate. So these motors are also as usually having two main windings. One main winding is in two sections. Okay, so they can be comprised of two main windings, or it is having one main winding in two sections and one starting winding. So with suitable number of LEDs brought out, these are changed over from one voltage to other voltage. So if it is into 110 volts, we can change it to 220. If it is in 220 volts, we can change it to 440. Okay, so when the motor is to operate from lower voltages, the two main windings will be connected in parallel. Whereas if you want to use for higher voltage, they are connected in series. The starting winding will be always operated on low voltage because as it is connected across one of the main windings. Okay, we have to remember that starting winding is operated on every low voltage. This is two voltage non-reversible type. Next one, two voltage reversible type. So in before sessions, we cannot reverse. Here we can reverse. That is the difference only. So for reversing, we have to bring out the LEDs outside externally. We have to connect them externally so that we can
reverse them easily. So external reversing is made possible with two means of two additional leads. Those are brought out from the starting winding. See here, from the starting winding, we can see here two additional, this one, two additional. So this is for clockwise rotation. First figure is for clockwise rotation and second one is for anti-clockwise rotations. Okay, so in both, if you observe that the motor is operated on low voltages. Similarly, wiring diagram can also be drawn for higher voltage supply also. Seventh one. Single voltage, three lead reversible. Okay, so here we can see that there are three leads here, A, B and C. Three leads are brought out. In such motors, we are using two sections. Running winding is used. Two sections of running winding is used. So two sections. First section is called as R1 and second section is R2. These are internally connected. R1 and R2 are internally connected. And from those, one of the lead of starting winding is connected to the midpoint. See here, one of the starting winding is connected to the midpoint of running winding. And the second lead of the starting winding is brought outside like this. So when the external lead of the starting winding is connected to point A, and this is A and this is B. So when the starting winding lead connection is connected to point A, the winding is connected across R1. And when the R1 is working, the rotor will be rotating in clockwise directions. So when the letter of the starter is connected to B here, it is connected across R2. Then the current will be flowing through the starting winding will be reversed. Here like this, it will be flowing. The current will be flowing in the reverse direction. So the rotor will be rotating, the motor will be rotating in the anti-clockwise or counter-clockwise directions. Okay, next one. This is single voltage instantly reversible type. Suppose if you are using a single voltage instantly reversible type, instantly it can be reversed. By we are taking out the leads, four leads externally and we are connecting. So it is not instantly done, it is manually done. So for instantly reversible done, we have to do it within seconds. So normally a motor will be brought to complete rest and then started in reverse direction. If you want to start the motor in reverse direction, what will be you done? You have to stop the motor and until it gets to the speed zero, then we have to reverse the direction. Why? Because the centrifugal switch cannot close unless the motor has practically stopped. It is designed to so that the switch is operated when the motor is stopped only, completely stopped only. Okay, so as the starting winding is disconnected from the supply, when the motor is running, the reversal of starting winding leads will not affect because the operation of the motor, if you change the starting winding terminals also, as we go on with the induction motor, as it runs normally, the starting winding will be turned off. So what is the use of changing the starting winding leads for reversing? So there will be no effect. So the reversal is achieved by a triple pole double throw, TPDT switch, three pole double throw switch, which I have shown in the figure. This is TPDT switch. So this switch consists of three blades or poles. It consists of three blades or poles which move together as one unit in either of the two positions. Okay, so the TPDT switch is having three blades or three poles. these are connected to only single base. So they will entirely move as a one unit. The three poles will be moving as a one unit in either directions, two directions, two positions. So that is three poles. It is having two positions it can. So double throw. So in one position of the switch, what I have shown you in figure, motor will be running in clockwise direction. In this position, the motor will be running in clockwise. And in other one, the motor is running in anti-clockwise directions. Obviously, what happens in this type of arrangement, there is necessary to wait until the motor stops before arrangements. So in certain applications, we need some instant reversal. While the motor is operating at full speed only, we have to change the reverse the switches. So what happens, what is needed now? A relay will be fitted in the circuit. It short circuits the centrifugal switch and connects the starting winding in the circuit in the reversal position. Okay, by using the relay, it is possible. So if you want to instantly change the speed of the direction of the motor, we have to take one relay and we have to short circuit the centrifugal switch and connect the starting winding in the circuit in reverse direction. So that, see here, in reverse direction. So that if you close or open the relay, the directions will be changed. So it is seen that here when the motor is at rest, the double contact centrifugal start is in start position. When at rest, it is in start position. Okay, centrifugal switch will be in start position. In the position, there are two connections to be made. In this start position, there are two connections. First one, the starting winding and capacitor C are placed in series across the supply line. And the coil of the normally closed relay is connected across C. These are the two functions going on when the capacitor switch is in start position. What are them? The starting winding and the capacitor C are placed in series across the supply line. And the coil of the normally closed relay is connected across C. Okay, so when the TPDT switch is in two positions, see here, forward and reverse, what happens we will see. So when the TPDT switch is in forward position, first happens, what happens means running winding is connected across the line. This running winding is connected across the lines. So running winding is connected across the line and second one is this running winding is connected across the lines. And second thing, starting winding and C are in series across the line. These are also in series across the line. Okay. And third one is relay coil is connected across the C. This relay coil, this is the relay coil. This is connected across the C. So the voltage developed across the C is applied across the relay coil. This results in opening of the relay coils. So with the increase in speed of the motor, the centrifugal switch is again thrown into the running position. This cuts out C from the circuit and leaves the starting winding in series with the relay coil. As the relay is having a high resistance, it only permits enough current through the starting winding so that the relay coil will open, the contacts will be getting open only. In fraction of seconds, if you use this TPDT switch, in fraction of seconds, the switch is shifted from forward to reverse positions. So when it is shifting from forward to reverse positions, no current will be flowing through the relay. So as a result, if no current flows through the relay contacts will be closed. So now the relay will be, the TPDT switch will be thrown into the reverse position. And the current flows through the closed relay contacts to the starting winding, but it is as it is in reverse position, in the opposite direction there will be flowing. So there produces here the this produces a torque which is applied to the direction opposite to the rotation here. So we can assume, we can conclude two points from this. First one, the rotor is immediately brought to rest, first one. And second one is the centrifugal switch falls to start position here, start position. So as the before C is put in series, the starter winding and the motor starts rotates in opposite direction. This is the single voltage instantly reversible switch. And next, ninth one, two speed type. So here speeds can be changed from high to low. As you are in the figure, as you are shown in the figure, from high switch to low switch, we can change the speeds. These speeds can be changed by changing the number of poles in the windings. Okay, so for this purpose, we are keeping two separate running windings in the slots of stator. One is of 6-pole winding and other one is of 8-pole windings. Only when we are using starting winding, one with 6-pole winding is used and others will be of 8-pole winding. Okay, so when the starting winding is used here, again we use always this winding will be, the starting winding will be always acts in conjunction to the high speed running winding. It acts a winding to the high speed running winding. So the double action or this transfer type centrifugal switch has two contact points on the start. One on the start side and other on the run side. Start side and other on the run side. Here we are using an external switch for changing the motor speed. Okay, so the motor will always start on high speed. Always starts on high speed, irrespective of whether the switch is in high position or low position. Okay, so whether the switch is in high or low contact, always the motor will be started on high speeds. If the speed is set on low, suppose if the switch is set on low, then as soon as the motor comes up to the speed, the centrifugal switch first do two things. First one is it cut out the starting winding. The starting winding is cut out and high speed running winding is cut out. And high speed, this one, high speed running winding is cut out. After that, second thing it will do is it cut out the lower speed running winding also. These are the functions of centrifugal switch. And next, last one, two speed with two capacitor type. Two capacitors are used and two speeds are used. Okay, so this motor has two running windings. What are they? Two starting windings and two capacitors. Okay, so totally it is having two capacitors, two running windings, high running winding and lower running winding, and two starting windings, high starting winding and low starting winding. One capacitor is used either from off to, one capacitor is used for high speed operation and other capacitor is used for low speed operations. A double centrifugal switch is employed for cutting out the starting winding after the starts. So these are the types of capacitor start motors. Now we will see other type of motor, capacitor start and run motor. So in all these 10 types, we saw that the capacitor start motors means at the time of starting only the capacitor is present. So by using a centrifugal switch, we are cutting out the capacitor when the induction motor runs to the normal speed.
Okay, so here what will happen if you put the capacitor at the running time also, we will see now. So that is called as capacitor start and run motors. Okay, so this capacitor is present at the time of starting and at the time of running also. Here we can see capacitor start winding, starting winding and running winding. Okay, here we are not taking any switch because we are not disconnecting the capacitor and starting winding at the time of running of induction motor. Just we are keeping as is from the start to off position. Here it is similar to capacitor start motor, except the starting winding and capacitor are connected in all the times. So what is the advantage means the what is the advantage of leaving the capacitor permanently in the circuit means, first one, it improves the load capacity, overload capacity of the motor. If any overload occurs, it improves the overload capacity. The motor does not get damaged, so it improves the overload capacity. And second one, it gives higher power factor. Due to this capacitor, we will get higher power factor. And the efficiency will also be low. Sorry, higher efficiency. Efficiency will also be high. And last one is, it has quieter running operations. Means without any sound, the motor will run quietly. So this advantage, this seems to be advantage, and it is most desirable for small power drives when we are using in offices or laboratories. So we need there a low noise motor. So it is applicable there. And some of the motors which start and run with one value of capacitance in the circuit are called as single value capacitances. Okay, and so these are called as single value capacitor run motors. Okay. Because there will be two types of capacitors here. One, we can use one capacitor for running and starting purposes, or we can use two capacitors here. So first capacitor is used for starting purpose and second capacitor is used for running purposes. So if we want to start with two capacitors, then we have to start with the high value of capacitance, and at the time of running we have to switch to the low value of capacitance. This is called as two value capacitor run motors. If you use single capacitor, then it is called as single value capacitor run motors. And if you want two capacitors for different running positions, it is called as two value capacitor run motors. Now we will see them briefly. Single value capacitor run motors and two value run motors. Okay, so the diagrams I am showing you is about the single value capacitor run motors. It has only one capacitance. It has one running winding and one starting winding. So these running winding and starting windings are in series with the capacitance. So as we know that this capacitance will be present, it will be remaining in the circuit permanently. This motor is referred to as permanent split capacitor run motor. And it behaves like an unbalanced two-phase motor. So what it is called as? It is permanent split capacitor run motor. And it will be behaving as an unbalanced two-phase motor. So there is no need of centrifugal switch used here because capacitance is permanently present here, then there is no need of cutting out the capacitance and starting windings. So as the capacitance is used for starting, single capacitance is used for both starting and running windings, it is neither optimum starting or neither optimum running performance can be obtained, because we have to choose the value of capacitance such that it must be adaptable for both starting and running positions. In this, the capacitance range will be chosen as 2 to 20 microfarads capacitance. And these are most expensive. These are called as oil or pyranol insulated foil paper capacitors. Because why we are adopting this means because they have continuous duty rating. As we take a low value of capacitance, it results in small starting torque. This small starting torque will be about 50 to 100% of the rated torque. So consequently, these motors are used where the required starting torque is low, such as air moving equipments that are air moving means in the air when the moving equipment is there, we can choose for these capacitances. So example, fans, blowers, voltage regulators, and also oil burners, where we need a quiet operation, which is practically desirable. And either unique feature of this type of motor is it can be easily reversible by an external switch. And for this reversible, we have to see here forward and reverse. We have to take externally this switch and we have to provide that running and starting windings are same. Okay, so one serves as a same, that means A and B two windings we have to take, but these two should be same, similar, A and B. So one will be acting as a starting winding for both of, for winding for one direction of rotation, and other serves as a running winding for the reverse directions. So for reverse rotation, the one which is, suppose if you take in forward direction, suppose A will be running and B will be starting. In reverse direction, it will be reversed. A will be starting and B will be running. Okay, so the running and starting windings which are in forward direction, they will get reversed in the reverse direction. And such reversible motors, these are often used for operating devices that move back and forth very frequently. Suppose if you take a rheostat or induction regulations or furnace controls or valves and arc welding controls, in those what happens, the motor will be operating reverse and back, for front and back, forth and back regularly. So for this, we have to use this capacitor start run motors or for single value capacitor run motors. And two value capacitor start motors, we will see. In those, we have to take the applications where we need a high starting torque, heavy starting torques, we can use the two value capacitor run motors. So if you see the torque here, full load torque to speed curves here, see here the torque, it is having only at speeds, as the speed increases the torque increases, and after the maximum torque attained, if you increase the speed also, the torque will be reducing. So these are used for low torque applications. So see here, 20, 40, 60, as we increase the speed, the torque will be increasing like this linearly. And after you attain the maximum speed here, the torque will be again decreasing. So until now, the torque is stable, and after that, it will be decreasing. So this is the capacitor start run motor of a single value capacitor run motors. And now we can go for second one. Two value capacitor run motors. This is two value capacitor run motors. In this we can see that there are two types of capacitors shown here. One is A and B. One is used for starting purposes and one is used for running purposes. So this motor will be starting with the high capacitors in series with the starting windings so that we can obtain high starting torques. So for running on low capacitors, it is sustained by a centrifugal switch. Both the running and starting windings will be remaining in the circuit only. How can we obtain the two value capacitances means? By using the two capacitances in parallel at the start and then switching out one for low value run. Or we can use other step by using a step up auto transformer in conjunction with one capacitor. So the effective capacitance value is increased for the starting purposes. This auto transformer, this is normal capacitor starter. This we will discuss in next class.